First, let me welcome you to this press conference. We felt it important that we have this important conversation with you and with Kenyans who have been supporting the Inject Party to this day. And this far we've come is because Kenyans have offered us their unwavering support, and we do not take it for granted. And we feel that every once in a while, we should create an opportunity to communicate to them, give them the progress, where we've come from, where we are, where we believe we are heading, the challenges we have, and how we hope to overcome them. So I'm here with the Secretary General of the party, Solon Kapareno. He's going to read a statement, then we're going to accept some questions, then I guess that will be it for today. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, members of the press. And the party statement, or the official standing of the party, is as follows. The Inject Party continues to affirm its unwavering commitment to the people of Kenya, strengthening our presence and structures while holding the government accountable for its promises. Through our united and dynamic team led by Morara Kibaso, we have grown the movement, and true to it, many corners in the country right now are in the millions shouting Inject Change. In the past 2 months, the Inject Party has traversed more than 30 counties, engaging directly with citizens to highlight pressing issues and government shortcomings. Our initiative, the Vampire Diary, started by Morara Kibaso, has spotlighted critical areas of failure in the current regime, shedding light on stalled projects that have long plagued development within counties and nationally. Our efforts have resulted in tangible progress, as you can see. From the Kanyagwal Fisheries Project in Kisumu to the Rombo Tomato Agro-Processing Facilities in Letoktok, all these projects are currently being revived, but more still needs to be done. These achievements underscore our commitment to ensuring that this administration is held accountable and responsible for the development of this nation. At the core of our party's success lies a robust and cohesive structure built around a skilled and passionate team, you can see them here, that operates on a voluntary basis. All the members you see before you operate on a voluntary basis. No one is being paid. And again, our success lies with the millions of Kenyans who have joined us in their own way. And this is a testament to their belief in our cause and to their commitment to the Kenyan people. It is important to clarify that all public donations to the party are accounted for. There are systems and mechanisms that are in place to ensure integrity and proper utilization of all donated funds. There is a 14-member team that is in charge of all matters finance. And as a matter of fact, the financial reports are always available for scrutiny at the party headquarters. This structure of accountability and transparency distinguishes the Inject Party as a beacon of integrity in the political landscape. As we move forward, the Inject Party remains steadfast to its mission of addressing systemic failures, championing development, and advocating for solutions that resonate with the daily struggles of Kenyans. We invite all Kenyans to join hands with us in building a better future, one where the leadership is synonymous with accountability, service, and action. This is a joint fight that we cannot fight alone, and we need everyone to play a role. The government and many political elite are not happy with us, and they are out there to disrupt and divide our movement. But what we have to say to them is we will not relent, we will not be shaken, and we will not be distracted by those who have personal interests and those who have succumbed to the pressure. The Inject Party is more than a political party. It is a movement that is driven by the shared vision of hope, prosperity, and unity for all Kenyans. Together, we will continue to make strides that reflect the strength and determination of our nation. Na tunaamini ya kuwa tutabadilika. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. So we believe we can take questions now. Okay, so I don't know whether the first question is to me or to the Secretary General. So the Inject Party FIRST stands for Inclusion of National Justice and Civic Transformation. That's what Inject stands for. Now, Inject Party is a party that was born by the Kenyan people. It's not really our thing. It is something that came from Kenyans. We are only privileged to serve Kenyans. Now, since we started the process of registration of a party to where we've reached today, we've had only one interim secretary general. We've never had two or three. And the interim secretary general has always been Solon Kapareno. So anybody out there purporting, claiming, or otherwise saying that they were or could be or should have been the secretary general, that is not true. However, he holds that position on an interim basis, because when you're registering a political party, you need interim officials before the actual officials can be elected at the National Delegates Conference. So when we finally have the National Delegates Conference, the officials of the party will be elected to replace the interim officials. And the interim officials, if they want to run for that position, they'll run and get the true mandate of the people. As at now, he is the one who holds that office and continues to run that function. With regards to people holding a press conference to say they were members and they've left, what we can say is that first, we saw it. We were also disturbed, as you were, and we were worried, as you were. Some of the people we saw there, we've never met them. We don't know them. We are meeting them for the first time. However, there are some that we know that have been here maybe once or twice. They've come and participated in a meeting or two. And the main point of departure between our value system and their value system is that they expected that at Inject Party, they would be paid heavy salaries for roles within the party. But what we are communicating today is that the work we do here is voluntary. Whatever we receive from Kenyans is only enough for fuel and security. Sometimes we go into our own pockets to pay our own accommodation when we go for Vampire Diaries. We go into our own, personally, I've gone into my own pocket to even finance purchase of some furniture, to pay even some workers. So it's just not sufficient to make everybody as comfortable as they want to be. Remember, what we receive from Kenyans is out of goodwill, and it can only assist us to facilitate the work of civic education. It's not for our own comfort or for us to enjoy life. So I'm so sorry to them that we are not able to meet their expectations, but this is how things are, and they may have to get used to how the things are. Well, I don't know where the Cabinet Secretary, Honorable Hassan Joho, gets the time to even insult Kenyans on social media. Because those Kenyans who are on social media, if he says that they are idle because leaders like him, who are corrupt, have made it impossible for those young people to get opportunities, so they have a lot of time to be on social media. Secondly, I don't think that his level of education and intellect is one that would want to argue with. Okay, we are definitely more informed than he is, so we'd like him to attend classes so that we just educate him a little bit about our country. For example, I can educate him that there is 8.7 trillion worth of niobium at Mrima Hill in Lungalunga constituency in Kwale County that he needs to safeguard. There is money that is supposed to be remitted to the Kenyan government by Base Titanium, which has been doing mining operations in Kwale County and is winding up its operations this year. There is gold in Transmara constituency. There is even gold in Western Province. There is oil in Turkana. I believe his plate is full. Where he gets the time to do this kind of things is what I do not know. I believe he has a lot in terms of safeguarding our natural resources and not participating in corruption or in online social media skits with young people who are unemployed because of corrupt leaders like himself. So it will be unworthy of the Inject Party to engage with Ali Hassan Joho. We are a national party. Him is only a kingpin of some area in the coast of people, actually few people who believe in him. So we believe that even if we went to an election with Ali Hassan Joho, he would not garner a quarter of what we would garner in that election. So in this interview, it's completely worthless to have him as a conversation. He is just in the cabinet because he belonged to ODM, and ODM was bought into the coalition government. If ODM was not bought into the coalition government, he would probably be still doing the same social media that he is insulting people for. Yeah, so Ali Hassan Joho should get his act together, and President William Ruto should prevent his ministers, cabinet secretaries like Ali Hassan Joho, from insulting Kenyans who are already angry and hungry from the collapsing economy.